I do think BNN is a very inclusive environment.
When I started here in the Phoenix office, there was one other woman in the office, and now I think we're maybe more than 50%.
And I would say finally, to have passion and enthusiasm with everything you do.
Welcome to this episode of Infrastructure Insights. We're excited to celebrate Women's History Month by talking with some of the women at BNN about their experience in a traditionally male-dominated industry. I'm Nicole Foster, your host for the episode. Today, we are joined by Deborah Lohmeyer, Cynthia Alvarez, and Cardi Rodriguez, three of BNN's talented engineers, all at varying levels of experience in their fields. And they're going to talk about their accomplishments, careers, and overall experiences as women in the architecture, engineering, and construction industry. Welcome. We're excited to have you all as first-time guests for our Women in Engineering podcast. To help our listeners get to know each of you, could you please introduce yourselves and tell us your current role at BNN, maybe some information on your education and how you ended up here? Let's go around and starting with Cynthia.
Okay. Cynthia Alvarez, I am a transportation project manager in our Phoenix office. I have been with BNN for going on 8 years here in June. I got my Bachelor of Science in Civil Engineering from Northern Arizona University, which is just 2 hours north of Phoenix. And basically, since graduation, I've been here at BNN doing transportation planning, a little bit of roadway design, a little bit of traffic, so just everything kind of like the transportation realm.
Nice. Okay. How about Deb?
Lohmeyer. I'm Deb Lohmeyer. I am out of Southeast Virginia. I actually work with Nicole, which is a lot of fun. I've got close to 30 years of experience, and I've been with BNN for 18 of those, so I obviously like it here a lot. I graduated from ODU with a degree in mechanical engineering, and then I went on and got my MBA from William & Mary. And I really enjoyed both of those programs immensely. In my current role, I'm the Southeast Virginia District Director, so I manage our Richmond and Norfolk operations, which includes a lot of different variety of type of engineers and architects. So we've got architecture, facility engineers, so mechanical, electrical, plumbing, and fire protection. We also have civil engineers that include land development and utility infrastructure. So we touch a lot of different types of projects, which makes it a lot of fun.
Nice. Great. And how about you, Cardi?
Yeah, hello. I'm Cardi Rodriguez. I'm from Venezuela. And I work as a traffic project manager in the Florida District. My office is located in Tampa, Florida. I am working in traffic design projects, basically setting up and marking on the street, traffic signals, street lighting. Lately, I have been having the opportunity to work with a local government in the Tampa Bay area, where we are producing or preparing a transportation design manuals, developing kind of guidance for transportation design principles. I got my bachelor on civil engineering in my home country, Venezuela, in Universidad de los Andes. And I also got a master's degree here in USF, University of South Florida, in 2018. From there, when I was finished my master's degree, I started working on Icon Consultant Group here in Tampa. We get acquired by BNN on 2020. So basically, I have been working on Icon BNN my whole career since I'm graduate from USF, basically.
That's awesome.
Awesome. So you each told us a little bit about how you got into engineering through your education. Was there a role model in your life that inspired you to enter the career? How did you decide your specific discipline? Sort of what was your motivation?
Starting with me again, Cynthia?
Sure.
So I wouldn't say I had a particular role model. I think just since I was really young, I always was really good at math, really good at science. And, you know, kind of as I went through the school years doing the like career aptitude test and all of that, I would consistently get results that were STEM related. And so one of those was civil engineering. So I started to look into that a little bit more. Decided, you know, it sounds really interesting. And then, you know, decided to pursue that when I went to college. And as you know, within year one, I was like, yep, I know I made the right choice. Like, I am lacking all the classes that I'm in, like, this all seems interesting. And then specifically with transportation, I initially thought I wanted to do structures or water coming out of college. And then I started at VNN, and sort of the work that we were doing here was more transportation related. And it actually ended up being a really good fit because I love what I do now and I love the transportation piece of it. So it was kind of just like I landed in something. And one of the things that I tell a lot of people is, like, even though, especially like young engineers, like trying to find a job, is if you can't find specifically what you're looking for, be open to other things, because you just never know what you're going to end up at. And you may end up liking that even more than you thought you would. So.
Great.
Yeah, that's awesome feedback. My path mirrored a lot of Cynthia. You know, I was always good at math and science, and the school aptitude test always said, oh, you should be an engineer or a doctor or something like that. So, it was something I always gravitated to. It was easy for me. I remember back in middle school in geometry class, I was always so excited because I could just see in my head the answers for all the theorems. And all my other schoolmates, I think, ended up hating me because I was such a curve buster with them. But I just geeked out with all of the things math related. So I went ahead and applied for engineering school. And at the time, I really did not know, honestly, what engineers do. I'm almost embarrassed to say that. I applied for a degree that I didn't know a lot about. So I started out in civil engineering, and within the first semester, I transferred over to mechanical. I really enjoyed a lot of the thought process and analytical thinking, the risk assessments, those types of things, as well as the diversity of type of projects that I would be able to work on. Being able to touch everything from automobiles to planes to HVAC systems, a lot of different types of things. So it's been a lot of fun for me in my career to have those diversity of types of projects.
Very nice, very interesting.
Great.
In my case, yeah. Even when my dad is a doctor and my mom is a teacher, I never got considered those roles. That was fun. So however, I got cousins in my family that they were studying engineering at that time. I was very close to them, and I usually enjoy to listen to them just talking about all the engineering stuff and count the way that they solve problems through the engineering, make me think, okay, this is the role, not my parents' things. I got more something like that. So it was the first time that I wanted to have this one. So I was kind of struggling what area to choose. In this case, civil, or they were electrical, system, computer related, but I wanted something more tangible that you can touch, that you can see, like a building, like a bridges. So I said, no, definitely it's going to have to be civil. So that's the reason behind this one. And now for the master that I pick on civil engineering, I got the opportunity again. Okay, you can choose several things, but I focus on the transportation because this is funny. When I used to come here to the United States to go to Disney World as a vacations, all the time that I came, it was a construction, a highway in construction and different designs. And every time I say, how it can happen? I mean, it was for me like a too much, and really want me to say, if I do something here, I really want to do something related with transportation and being involved on all these type of things. And amazing, today I'm here, and it's unbelievable. The things that you just think where you are even younger, you can project it and you can do it ahead. So this is basically how I ended up here in the traffic area.
Wow, those are all great stories. And so you all sort of touched on this, the skills that you've picked up and the passions that you've developed along the way. What are some skills that you've learned that you think are important for engineers to have? Obviously, analytics. What are some others?
I think one of the things that you don't really learn in school, you know, we all sort of get very similar educations going through an engineering degree. But the things you don't learn in school are the people skills, communication, I think even report writing. I know I do a lot of report writing, even just emails or proposals. There's a lot of that. And so knowing how to develop technical content, I think, is a big piece. And then the communication piece, like, you know, everyone makes the joke about engineers being introverts and whatnot, which I feel like isn't, I see it at BNN and I don't feel like that applies entirely, which is great. But, you know, we are still, you know, kind of to ourselves. And so those communication skills, I think, are critical to advance your career, because you have to coordinate with people, you have to communicate. And, like, you know, without that communication, things get lost in the details. So I think that that's my number one.
Very good points.
Yeah, that's actually my number one as well. So I think when I was getting ready to graduate from high school, I had always a love of engineering or science, math and science, as well as English. And I actually thought about majoring in English at one point because I just loved writing so much. And it's interesting how different that is with a lot of typical engineers. And I agree with Cynthia, there's not a lot of those typical engineers here at BNN. We all Agreed. Typically are pretty good communicators, but you have to have a really solid ability to communicate well, both orally and in writing, and being able to create solid documents that are easily understandable, searchable, that everybody in the community can go through and read. Also develop solid plans and specs to go with those. But the communication is really the foundation of how all of that comes together. Sitting in meetings and being able to delve into what the key concerns are for the client and the community, being able to make that understandable so that those types of themes are carried on throughout the entire project. No two projects are the same. No two communities are the same. So being able to listen and distill that information and communicate it back to the design team is really, really critical. So I would say both oral and written communication skills are equally as important to the engineering side.
Yeah, I totally agree with both Cynthia and Dev for the same thing, yeah. Yeah, and also have like a three important, for me, important skills that an engineer should have. And the first, I will say like a critical, critical reasoning thinking, right? To be able to solve a project in a logic way, applying all your knowledge that you have and see what will happen next. To have that thing, okay, doing this one, it can be happen like that. I always say engineering had that capacity to go more, a little more. That's for me is an important skills. A second one, I will say emotional intelligence, kind of. You know that we as an engineer, we want to solve problems immediately. So to be able to motivate all the engineers and bring all together with a common solution, I think is a key to my job and to anything. Because there's brilliant people there, but as an engineer, we got to struggle to communicate and to be able to get together. So emotional intelligence, I think, is important in that part. And I would say, finally, to have passion and enthusiasm with everything you do. You can do a very complicated design and a super easy task. But if you do this one with a lot of passion and enthusiasm, I think you got it. You do the things right and you do your 100%. So I would say those are important general skills for me, for an engineer.
I agree.
Awesome. All good feedback. So a few of you touched on the sort of the culture at BNN in your answers. So we'll sort of shift the conversation in that direction. What would you consider to be a professional accomplishment you're most proud of? And how has it affected you personally or impacted you in the community? Any order that you want.
So I think a couple years ago, I was elected as an associate at BNN. And for me, that was a really big accomplishment. It just kind of was my reward for all of my hard work over the years with BNN. And so it felt really great to be recognized. And I think that that has also kind of given me more opportunities to further my career, which I really like at BNN. They're very supportive of that kind of, if you work hard, they will reward it. So I really appreciate that. And then from a project standpoint, there was a project here that was maybe 2 or 3 years long, and it was the Maricopa County Department of Transportation System Plan. And that project ended up getting a few awards, which was really nice, again, just to be recognized for your efforts. And it was also for me personally, I spent a lot of time on it. It was also a time that, like, my supervisor allowed me to lead big tasks. And so it was a time for me to sort of grow and develop my skills as well.
Awesome.
So from a leadership perspective, I would say that being nominated an owner of Burgess & Nyepel was probably an accomplishment I'm really proud of. It was back in 2011, and there was another female engineer that was nominated at the same year. And I believe we were the first two technical engineers to be nominated as full shareholders. Prior to that, the other shareholders that were female were in the HR and finance groups. So that was a really big accomplishment that still to this day, I'm really, really proud of.
As you should be.
From a technical perspective, I'm really proud of the diversity of type of projects that I've been able to work on and touch in my career. I've been fortunate to work on a fast track design build project where we designed a class one pharmaceutical laboratory for Pfizer in 6 weeks to be able to get the flu vaccine out on the street in time. I've worked on a lot of really exciting pump station and infrastructure improvements to some of our local communities that were having a lot of failing issues. I worked at NASA both personally early in my career, and now I have the opportunity to work with them as a consultant, both on some exciting renovations and construction projects, and those are pretty neat. And then I've had an extensive array of projects that I've done for the federal government at military installations literally across the country from coast to coast. So that's been really rewarding as well. So it brings me personally a lot of joy knowing the type of projects that both I've had the opportunity to work on and the people in my team have had the opportunity to be engaged on, with just really improving our built environment and the communities where we're living and working and where we're engaging with others. So
that's really nice. That sounds really good.
Yeah.
And in my case, I will say I feel proud of every project that I just had the opportunity to touch, honestly, because again, we try to do everything from heart and to do our best on everything. But I will say, and I've been more kind of to have the opportunity to be involved in projects that are outside of my comfort zones, I will say those are the ones who get me more proud. As you know, that I'm a traffic design by experience. And as I mentioned before, I had the opportunity to work for the local government here in Tampa. We're creating through them a transportation design manual. And this one, I was completely outside of my comfort zone again, gave me the opportunity to be more external with the clients, to improve my writing, to improve my presentation skills. And it has been so much fun to try different topics that I didn't did before. So that made me feel so proud about, like, you can do it at that beginning for this one. And as far as the local community, the transportation design manual will provide guidance for to improve safety and to provide alternative modes of transportation for the community. So this is kind of a good package in general for this.
That's great. And I mean, you know, it's got to be nice to challenge yourself and not do the same thing every day, which is, you know,
really powerful.
Yeah. So we'll do a round robin again. From the time you started, has your experience as a woman in the engineering industry shifted over time?
I think for me, when I started here in the Phoenix office, there was one other woman in the office, and now I think we're maybe more than 50%, wow. Which is amazing to see. And it's been 8 years, but you know, kind of, it's been a long time, but also not that long. And so it's great to see that. And even just, you know, doing interviews for interns or just talking to other people in the industry, they notice, they say, oh, you guys have a lot of like women in your office. Like, that's great. So I really appreciate that. And I'm seeing that change in the industry. And I think just if you also just like look at statistics, there's more women enrolling in engineering also. So I think that, you know, things are changing for the good.
Nice.
Yeah, I agree. When I was in college, it was amazing how few engineers there were or female engineers there were in all of the classes. And we kind of stuck out at the time. And now I feel like we blend in a lot more than we did back 30 plus years ago when I was in college. About 20 years ago, I got a phone call from a client we were working with at the time about a mechanical issue they were having in one of their schools. And I won't say the client name or anything like that, but I remember that I went out to the job site and was looking around at the problems. And he said, Well, I'm your worst nightmare because I'm a mechanical engineer and I'm a male chauvinist pig. And I was like, oh, okay. And I just smiled at him and I said, all right, well, I thought this was going to be a boring problem. Let's take a look and see what you've got. And I just handled it with grace and maturity. And over the course of that project, he really grew to respect me as not only an engineer, but a female as well. So interestingly enough, he ended up being one of my references here at Burgess and Ipel when I applied here. So you can tell we actually got to be friends over that period of time, which was really, really nice. I don't experience a lot of those types of personalities, which is a good thing. These days, I think the communities are a lot more respectful of engineers and females overall. So it's something that it's no longer, oh, well, that's something I'm not used to seeing, a female engineer. It's something that is a lot more in the vocabulary, which is really, really refreshing.
Sure. Seems you made quite the impression, Deb.
Yeah. Yeah. I go to dinner with him and his wife still to this day. So he became a good friend of mine. So it's interesting.
That's really a nice history to share. Yeah, and I completely agree with Cynthia and with Deb. I mean, now there are more engineers in the industry comparing when I started, same thing when I was in college. I mean, and even for Deb, she'll be even worse because she's mechanical. And I remember the mechanical was just only one in the class, so even worse, yeah. But now I can see more women has achieved higher roles in the engineering field. So you can see growing and growing and growing. It's not even half. It has been really super fast growing that industry for women in the engineering field. So very nice.
Yeah, and for those who have been at other firms, how would you say women are represented at BNN compared to those past experiences, which obviously there's a time difference, and we've sort of acknowledged that. But do you think that BNN does a fairly good job at having a diversified workforce?
I do, and not only just a diversification for gender, but also different backgrounds, different cultural backgrounds, different levels. So having females engaged at different levels from entry level to senior, I think is really important from a mentoring perspective, as well as for a diversity of thought and decision making. I think women a lot of times approach problems with a little bit more empathy than maybe our male counterparts. I do think BNN is a very inclusive environment, so I've never felt different or judged as a female in any way. They've always appreciated and respected any of the contributions I've made, and I think that goes across the company. It's not just something specific to one region or another.
I agree with you, Deb. I think it's company-wide.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
And what do you think some other consulting firms could do, or the industry in general, to attract more female engineers?
Well, I would say I would like to see more women engineers going to higher schools and communicate the accomplishments, mm-hmm. you know, to all the females and share with them all the exciting project that they have been working on it. And also be able to say, I mean, like you can have a family, you can have a husband, children, and even with this one, have a balanced life to have both, to be a successful, very smart career to help you and also have a balanced life to live with this one. I think that's important.
That's a good point. Good point mm-hmm. to let them see that.
Right. I think a lot of people assume that you can't have that and have a very high stress position as an engineer. But I find so much joy in everything I do that, yes, there are stresses with it, but it's exciting for me working through the solutions and coming up with the ideas. And a lot of people talk about work-life balance, and I agree completely. You can have that. You can have that feeling of gratitude for both your personal world and your professional world.
Agree.
Great points. So just to wrap things up, what advice would you give to women just starting in their career or to any girls who are thinking about pursuing engineering who maybe don't have the exposure that you guys maybe had, or maybe when you were young, what are the types of things that you would have wanted to hear?
I think what Cardi just hit on is having other women come into high schools or, you know, whatever it is, to just see that, you know, it is possible to achieve that, and that there are women in these leadership positions at engineering firms, and that they are successful. I think just kind of seeing it and having that resource, if possible, to ask the questions, even if it's just like someone coming into a classroom and talking once. Just like learning about it, being exposed to it, because kind of what, you know, Deb was saying, like, I didn't know about engineering very well until I started looking into it, because it's just, you know, I didn't have anyone around me. So just being, having that exposure. And then just as far as maybe any tips or any feedback would just be, just give it a try. If you are interested, just go for it. I think there are a lot of resources available to kind of help you through it. And I think there are a lot of systems in place now, especially to encourage women to go into STEM fields. So.
Yeah, I agree.
Good stuff.
I would also say to be curious and ask a lot of questions. There's always somebody who is wanting to help educate you and mentor you. There's not a day that's gone by, I think, in my career that I've not learned something from somebody. And that's really fun and exciting for me. So be sure to have your voice and talk and ask questions, and just be very curious, be a lifelong learner, really embrace that type of mindset. There's no two projects and no two solutions that are going to be the same. So really being able to come to things with fresh ideas and an innovative mindset, I think, is really important. And I think that stems from a lot of curiosity.
Yeah, that's really awesome. Good. And yes, the same idea. And I would say, if you're really interested and in science and enjoy technology, definitely the engineering will provide you an opportunity to have a successful career. And again, you can have a balanced life. You can have a life beside this one if you know how to accommodate. And I will just close this one, and I will use a quote from Walt Disney that say, if you can dream it, do it. So that's the same thing for them.
Love that.
Yeah, I love that one. That's what I say. I have
that's
to mention
good.
That.
That's good. Good way to close this out. Well, thank you guys so much for joining the podcast today. Any final thoughts before we end?
Well, I would say thank you for the opportunity for me to come from another country with a different language. When I started doing even working, I couldn't communicate very well. And I mean, engineering had given me the opportunity, you know, to be there, to be able to work in my area. And it's an awesome opportunity. So if I can do it coming for another background, a different thing, any woman can do it. I mean, there is no way for that. So, and also to be an in, I appreciate the opportunity, you know, to stay here, as well as you guys to invite me to the podcast to communicate part of my story and to share with Cynthia and Deb. But just listen to them is awesome. Feel so proud of who we are as a woman, as an engineer. So thank you for this.
Very inspirational.
Very. I don't want to say anything after that. That was wonderful.
But yeah, no, I think what Cardi said too is just, you know, getting to hear more about Deb and Cardi's story is great. And just kind of seeing how we all come from different backgrounds and different, you know, opportunities and kind of where we all landed, and we're all here to help each other. So it's great.
Yeah, agreed.
Yeah, I agree completely.
All right. Well, thank you guys.
Thank you.
Thanks.
Thanks for geeking out with us today as we celebrate Women in Engineering. Remember to subscribe to our podcast to get notified when the latest episodes come out. Check out our LinkedIn and Instagram pages too to keep up to date with what's happening at BNN.